capture, capture this.
All right, good evening. We are presenting on Big Brothers, Big Sisters, not only of Johnson County, but just all of America as well. Basically, what they do is just providing underprivileged kids with mentorship and how that changes their lives. I'm Austin Wilkins.
I'm Megan Plummer.
I'm Preet Moderate.
I'm Shea Wolf.
And we're going to start off with a little bit of overview for you guys. We're going to start with a personal story, what Big Brothers and Sisters Need is, a little bit about what they do, their goal, vision, mission, and accountability, some stats, and then we'll end it with how you guys can get involved. So I want to tell you guys about a personal experience that I had with Big Brothers and Sisters. This little girl up here is named Annie. She's 10 years old. I became her mentor about 3 years ago. And training to become her mentor, I was told many things. But one thing that really stuck with me was that a majority of the children in Big Brothers Big Sisters came from disadvantaged backgrounds, struggled with their schoolwork, or just had bigger problems going on in their personal lives. I was in the school-based program, so I would come to Annie's school about once or twice a week for 30 to 45 minutes, sometimes even an hour. During that time, we would do anything from I would help her with her schoolwork, we would watch movies, play board games, anything that she really wanted to do. After a couple weeks of getting to know her, I could tell something was wrong. I would ask her, but she would just kind of shy away from it. After finally finding out what was wrong, she said she was getting bullied by a couple girls. I asked what kind of bullying, and she said the girls were making fun of her because she wasn't wearing what they were wearing, and she couldn't afford to do what they were doing on the weekends. I asked her if she told her parents about it, and her response was, no, they wouldn't care. I asked her if she told her teacher, and she said, no, she was afraid to tell her teacher because she was afraid that her teacher would tell her parents, and then she would get in trouble by her parents. So after a couple more weeks of coming, I finally convinced her that telling her teacher would be the best solution to this problem. She finally told her teacher, and the bullying stopped, and I could see the impact that made on her. She not only improved on her schoolwork, but her attitude improved and her self-esteem improved. And all she needed was the push in the right direction, and that's what most of these kids need.
So how many of you guys have actually heard of Big Brothers, Big Sisters? Who actually knows what they do? All right, so hopefully a couple more of those hands will be up after this. A big thing they do is just providing mentorship. And here's some numbers that are pretty eye-opening on bullying. So 1 in 10 students drop out of school because of bullying. 90% 4th to 8th grade are reported being bullied. With the help of Big Brothers, Big Sisters providing that mentorship, and maybe their parents aren't giving them from the underprivileged kids. So with that mentorship, they could form that bond, and this way they can be able to reach out to their teachers if they're having trouble with college, or even their mentor through Big Brothers and Big Sisters, and be able to get these numbers from as big as they are now to dwindle them down, hopefully. So that's really what Big Brothers, Big Sisters is going for right now, and we'll talk to you a little bit more about that right now. So what Big Brothers Big Sisters is, they improve children's performance at school. Like Preet said, it's usually the school part of it. So the mentor could come in, help them with homework, watch some movies. If the little kid had a question about anything, they could help them out. That way they can help get better grades for them. Preventing youth alcohol and drug use also goes well with reducing physical aggressive behavior. Those who start drinking early, doing drugs, and behaving bad, usually when they're starting young, it's because they don't have someone to look up to. They really don't have that parent that's looking down on them to, make sure they're doing the right thing. That's what Big Brothers Big Sisters is for. They have that mentor that they can look up to. That way we can put those numbers going down, so we don't want the little kids getting into bad stuff like that they're going to. They can strengthen relationships with parents and guardians and peers. Maybe they don't feel like they have a connection with their parents or with their teacher maybe. With this mentor, maybe they can learn how to actually form that relationship with them, and that can carry over to talking to their teachers, talking to their friends, and also form that relationship that they should have with their parents. And also they have to learn about the importance of helping others. The mentors are coming in, they're helping their kids. These kids, hopefully, they see that and see the impact that it made on them, and maybe someday when they're closer to their mentor's age, they can give back the same way that their mentor did. So the goal of Big Brothers and Big Sisters is a couple different ones. Just to offer life-changing mentoring opportunities to Johnson County. That's the one that's here in Iowa City. They are all across the United States. They all have the same goal in mind, and that's just to help these kids get them, they reach their full potential in life. And basically, they just want to create a role model and a good friend. You know, the people who don't have friends or don't have that role model, those are the kids who get into drugs, alcohol, and they're heading down the wrong path. If they have that mentor in life, they can switch paths and get on that better path and have a great life.
So now that you know the goals and what Big Brothers Big Sisters is, I'm going to talk more about the core values of what makes up Big Brothers and Big Sisters. And that starts with the vision, which is very clear, and it's just they want to help all kids achieve success in life. And the mission they have set up, which goes directly with the vision, is they want to provide children with a mentor that can have a one-on-one relationship with the underprivileged children or any children, just so they can have someone to look up to, talk to, like Preet said, whether it's in bowling or they need help in schoolwork or simply just to hang out and have fun with because they don't have that opportunity at home. And lastly, they talk about accountability. And what's great about Big Brothers and Big Sisters is they pride themselves on partnering these kids and these families with a great mentor that not only are going to provide those things that the kids need, but they're also going to help achieve educational success, have the kids have higher aspirations in life, you know, make better decisions away from the classrooms, just form better relationships in life, and overall avoid risky behaviors because they have a mentor to look up to talk to, and to have in their life to make them more successful.
Okay, after we get to know a little bit more about what Big Brothers Big Sisters is and what they do, I'm going to introduce you some stats to further present you the idea of the relationship that the Big Brothers Big Sisters provide between the big and the small, and the littles. I'm sorry. And I believe this stats is very easy enough to give you the idea, very clear idea of the achievement that Big Brothers Big Sisters already obtained. So here's the proof. According to the national research, positive relationship between the big and the littles have a direct and measurable impact on the children's lives. So by participating in the programs, little brothers and little sisters are more confident in schoolwork performance, able to get along better with their families, 46% less likely to be using illegal drugs, which is important, 27% less likely to be using alcohol, 52% less likely to skip school, 95% of youth in our programs report improvement in our educational services, and 89% of youth in our program improve their ability to avoid risky behavior. So this sounds good, right? But not all things are perfect. So here are the reasons of why should we care. This is not perfect. So the volunteers are not enough. More than 70% of our children waiting for a big brother or a big sister are boys, but only 3 out of every 10 inquiries for volunteer came from men. Research shows that having the positive influence of a big brother makes a real difference in boys' life. There are 21,000 boys ready and waiting to be matched with the big brothers across the country. Right now, that's double the number of girls waiting for big sisters, which means we need to get involved.
So, like I said before, all these kids really need is just a push in the right direction. Now, if you don't have the time to volunteer or you're just really not interested, you can always donate. The donations go from anywhere to helping these kids get educated to having them put on events to help them do stuff like outside of school. You can volunteer and become a mentor. There's 3 opportunities for you guys. The community-based mentoring program, which if you don't feel comfortable going one-on-one, you can get together with the community, like a neighborhood, and just kind of play with the kids and like have them play with each other. And that has a minimum of 1 year commitment. Then there's the school-based mentoring, which I participated in, and that's an 18-month commitment, but 24 months are encouraged. And the reason that these commitments are so long is because you have to build a trust with these children, and like they're so used to not having a sturdy figure in their life that you are what they count on. You're the person they go to. They put their trust in you. And the last one is sports buddies, and that's kind of, that's 4 hours a month. It's very easy. I know they brought the Big Brothers Big Sisters to one of the football games here. They sat front row. They had a tailgate outside. They've also road trip down to Des Moines for Disney on Ice at the Wells Fargo Arena, so that's pretty cool, and that's where a lot of the donations go to. It's just to have the kids do something that's not outside of school. So now that you guys hopefully know a little bit about what Big Brothers Big Sisters is, you can spread the word if you have any family or friends that are interested in volunteering. And finally, just the relationships that Big Brothers and Big Sisters create, they're so real. And they impact not only the children's life, but I guarantee you they'll impact yours too.
And then that is the location for the one in Iowa City up on the top, and also the website as well as the national website if you guys want to get a little bit more information or found something that really stuck out to you guys. You guys can go ahead and give them a call or visit those websites. Any questions?
More about the process of how a certain child is placed with a specific mentor?
Yeah. So first you fill out like an application and you just kind of write your availability, what program you want to do, and then you'll go in and they interview you first to make sure you're a good candidate to be a big brother or big sister. And then after that they'll call you back, and then most people are welcomed into the program. But then it's like a whole day training process you'll go through, and they just kind of teach you about different situations that can occur during, you know, Big Brother, Big Sister, confidentiality, how that's a big one. And then they just kind of place you with a child. And if you get placed with a child that you're not very comfortable with, they encourage you to try to make a bond with them. But if it doesn't, then they'll rematch you with someone. But there's just so many kids in the program and not enough volunteers that. They actually came into high school when I was a sophomore, and they did like a volunteer bank, and everyone, you just put your name in. I just put my name in, not thinking I would get matched, and I did, and I still talk to Annie. She'll text me, like, she texted me last week, like, happy Thanksgiving, and now that I'm here, it's kind of hard to see her and stuff, but yeah, we still keep in touch.
Are any of you gentlemen big brothers?
No, we're not. Oh, I have looked into donating though, so I want to, after really, because I've heard of Big Brothers, Big Sisters, I've had friends do it, mm-hmm. But now that I actually know what they do, I'm definitely looking into seeing how I can get more involved.
I'm planning to get involved, but probably after graduation, so.
I've not been able to, but I've done numerous different mentorship opportunities that I have in school, but I haven't been able to get into Big Brothers, Big Sisters.
How are the children picked, I guess? Do they have to fill out an application to be admitted into the program, or?
It's kind of based on their parents. So a lot of these kids, it's not just disadvantaged. A majority of the kids in Big Brothers and Sisters come from disadvantaged backgrounds, but not all of them. Some can just be only child, and so they are born and their parents want them to be able to talk with people. It's just based on the parents. Some parents are like, I don't want my kid in this, and then that can cause tension between the teacher, because the teacher can also tell parents like, hey, I think this is a good opportunity for the child. So it just kind of, it's based all on the parents.
Okay.